donning a high-vis vest and vastly exaggerating the number of people who vote for him.
250 million people are not garbage.
Donald Trump created another spectacle for the waiting cameras.
How do you like my garbage truck? This truck is in honor of Kamala and Joe Biden.
The White House on the defensive over these comments from the outgoing president.
The only garbage I see floating out there is his supporters.
Joe Biden attempting to clarify he only referred to comedian Tony Hinchcliffe, who triggered a wave of outrage by calling Puerto Rico an island of floating garbage at a Trump event.
No, he does not view Trump supporters or anybody who supports Trump as garbage. That is not what he views.
Democratic strategists say Harris shouldn't apologize.
When President Biden spoke last night, that message did not step on what Kamala Harris said in her speech. And so he's recanted it. And I think he understood that it was a mistake. But that's not the way Kamala Harris feels.
Detroit down to Houston.
In North Carolina, Trump seizing on the apparent gaffe.
You can't lead America if you don't love Americans. You just can't.
While in the battleground state of Pennsylvania, where the latest polling puts Trump ahead by a point, the vice president distancing herself from Biden's comments while also accusing Trump of stoking division.
We have an opportunity in this election to turn the page on a decade of Donald Trump trying to keep us divided and afraid of each other. That is who he is. But Pennsylvania, that is not who we are.
Pennsylvania is a hard state. I've said this before. Even when Joe Biden was the nominee, it was very close. It's 50-50. And those numbers have not shifted that much. And so it's going to go down to the last day. It's going to go down to the wire.
Do you think there is a real danger here of Harris losing votes because of this?
Look, I mean, Donald Trump, the former president, has said many things over the last 8 years about the American people that have been way worse than any comment that has been made in the last 24 hours.
Joe and Jill Biden hosting a Halloween event at the White House. 6 days from the election with polls neck and neck, Democrats doing their best not to appear spooked. Tysock Husey, SBS World News.